country, they have to get a job, it is a struggle. Every single thing about their life seems to be a struggle. And at times it looks like they've come close to delivery. They can get close to the miracle, see the miracle, but for them to just even touch the miracle, it becomes a struggle. And today I want to deal with the other side of it. When after you have prayed and broken the spirit of struggle from your life, what you need is favor. Say favor. Say favor. Say favor. You know, favor is something that makes people different from the ordinary. Favor would make you so unique everywhere you go. A man with favor cannot be compared to a man without favor. A man with favor just gets miracles, breakthroughs, doors open for them. They don't struggle. The difference between what I taught on last week and what I'm teaching on this week is that a man that is going through the spirit of struggle or has the spirit of struggle struggles in everything they do, every endeavor of theirs, they struggle. But the opposite of struggle is favor. When you are favored, you don't struggle. When you are favored, you receive miracles. When you are favored, people just bless you. When you are favored, people just like you. And one will ask, what is favor? How do I position myself in order for me to also get this favor? You know, because if you are working with a man that is favored and your life is not favored, you think there is something wrong with you. If you're not even careful, you think that you are cursed. Because if you are walking on the road of success with a guy that is favored, you compare yourself with the guy and you think, what at all is wrong with me? Am I not praying enough? Am I not holy enough? What at all is wrong with me? There is nothing wrong with you most of the time. The problem is that the one that you are comparing yourself to has the anointing for favor. When someone is favored, trust you me, that is what the ordinary men call good luck. They are just lucky. You know, there are some people you can cast your mind back. Ever since you knew them, they don't struggle. For them, everything just happens. They get a job. They come to the country. They just got their papers. Life seems to be, every time, life seems to favor them. But as for you, every time, it looks like you have to struggle in one way or the other. But tonight, we are displacing struggle for favor. As you leave this place, you are dropping every spirit of struggle and you are walking out with favor. Anything that has not been working, the favor of God will superimpose every spirit of struggle in your life. If you are here, shout, I receive that. You know, one thing that I want to tell you before I go on to teach about this thing is that most the problem we make is that we do compare our lives with people. And that is why we get so depressed. The reason why we get depressed in life is that you are comparing yourself with that friend that you went to school with. You are comparing yourself with that sister of yours that is in the country. You are comparing yourself with that brother of yours, and the devil will let you know that, you see, that guy is succeeding. That guy has a good job. He's got a British passport. He's got a good family. Look at you. You have nothing. And the devil will speak to you and you feel so bad about yourself. But listen to me. Our identities and our destinies are not the same. You know, if you compare yourself with even your twin brother or your twin sister, you are making a mistake. Why? Because you don't carry the same destinies. You know, your destiny and that guy's destiny is different. You know, haven't you seen that most of the people that you began with and they were in school with, you went through high school with, they were so intelligent and so clever, and under normal circumstances, they are the people that are supposed to be at the top. But look at them where they are now. You can't even find them. Some are wretched. Some, their lives are not even good, even though they were so intelligent in class. The ordinary person will tell you the intelligent guy in class will be the one that will be rich in the future. But you see, life is not like that. Today, someone can be good. Someone can be up. But when God turns the table,
table and switches the ten, he will favor you and put you on the top pinnacle of life. I want you to understand, you carry a great destiny. The fact that something is not working for you now does not mean it will never work. God is about to show you a miracle. God is about to turn the tables around. The spirit of favor is about to be released on you. I know things might not be working. I know your brother is going far. I know that friend of yours is making it, and it looks like your life is retrogressing. But today I pray for you in the name of Jesus. May heaven release the spirit of favor to overtake your peers. May heaven release an anointing upon your life to make you overtake your peers. If anybody here, if your life it seems to be at one place and your friend seems to be advancing, I pray for you in Jesus' name. Receive divine enablement. Receive divine grace. Receive divine power to run faster. Whatever it is you seek to achieve, let the spirit of favor be released on you. Whatever it is you seek to accomplish, let the spirit of favor be released on you. From today, it shall not be a struggle, but the favor of God will come upon you. Men will say, you too, you are lucky. Men will say, you too, you are favored. Let that anointing of favor be released over your life. If you are here, shout, I receive it.
Listen to me. Sit down for a minute. You know, you carry a unique identity and you carry a unique destiny. Don't let anybody deceive you that you are going nowhere. Don't let anybody deceive you that life, because of how things are now, that is how things are going to be. I came to let you know, things are not just going to remain like this. I know it's difficult, but I hear the spirit of the Lord saying, a change is coming for you. A change is coming for you. A change is coming for you. Your life will not remain like this. And therefore, favor is coming to you. Your destiny will not remain like this. You too, you shall get married. Your life will not remain like this. You too, you shall get your British passport. Your life will not remain like this. You too, you shall break through. Your life will not remain like this. You too, you shall get a good job. If I hear, shout, I receive that.
Sit down. You know, when at times you compare yourself with the people you began with, it looks like, as for you, your life is delayed. Listen to me. Me, I don't care whether you are my friend or my brother, whether you have a private jet or you have 10 houses. It doesn't bother me. You know, I'm not even envious of anything. You know why? Because I know that it is just a matter of time. When the Lord God is through with them, he shall come to me. The Bible says that we serve a God who is able to do exceedingly, abundantly, far above what we think or even ask. And I pray that may that far above God do you a miracle. May that far above God give you a breakthrough. May that far above God show himself strong to you. If I hear, shout, I receive that.
Listen to me. I have seen people whose lives have been changed within a matter of 1 year. I've seen people whose lives have been changed within a matter of 6 months. I've seen people whose lives have been changed within a matter of a month. You know, most people, they don't believe in this, quick miracle. And, you know, we serve a God. It doesn't take God a year to change your life. God can change your life within 1 month. In fact, he can change your life within 1 week. In fact, he can even change it within a day. And may God shock you this week. In the coming week, may God change your destiny. In the coming week, may he surprise you. In the coming week, may you get a mind-blowing miracle. If you are here, shout, I receive that.
You know, I went to a place and I was ministering. I was walking through the crowd. I have it on DVD. And I was walking through the crowd. I just touched a guy and I said, you are seeing your hands with the hands of God. God is going to make you wealthy. You are going to have a lot of wealth. You are going to do a lot of business. And he sat down. And I said, you know what? We are releasing a seed. Come and release this seed. The guy did the seed and then he left. I left the town. Now listen to me. After a year when I went back, the same guy, he came to the office where I was doing counseling. And he said, man of God, you know, last year when you came here, I don't think you remember me because you spoke to a lot of people. He said, I was just a messenger in a shop.
But within a matter of a year, now I control, I am the sole dealer of, he mentioned a certain cosmetics name, of that cosmetics in the whole of this country. I said, wow. Just within a year, that guy that was just a messenger in a shop, God has changed his life to become a soul dealer and a great businessman. And he said, the next time you are coming to this country, I myself, I will buy your tickets. You understand? Someone that was just a messenger. And I said, God, so you can work miracles like this. You know, God can change the life of a man. You know, most of the time, these things we are saying at times, they look fishy to you. I have seen it. I have tested it. I have understood it. And I know what I'm talking about. If you serve God faithfully, trust you me, he shall give you a mind-blowing miracle that will change your destiny. And I promise you, before December, every one of you here, you shall get your own. I said, you shall get your own. I said, you shall get your own. I said, you shall get your own. If you are here, shout, I receive that. Paul said in 2 Corinthians chapter 10 verse 12, he said, for we dare not make ourselves of the number or compare ourselves with them that commend themselves, because they, by measuring themselves with themselves and comparing themselves among themselves, they were not wise. You know, when I started preaching, this was one of my favorite scriptures. I spoke on competition. It was one of my first sermons I preached on. 2 Corinthians chapter 10 verse 12. He said, Paul said, for we dare not make ourselves of the number or compare ourselves with them that commend themselves, because they, by measuring themselves with themselves and comparing themselves among themselves, they were not wise. In other words, if you compare yourself with somebody, you are a fool. You get what I'm trying to say? That is scripture. I'm just quoting from you what is in scripture. Some of the new versions actually put you are a fool. Are you hearing me? You don't have to compare yourself with anybody, because your destiny is different. Your thumbprint is different. Your mother is different. Your father is different. The time you came here on this planet, it is totally different. From today, I want you to have a mindset and move yourself from the comparison syndrome and know that God can also favor you. The spirit of favor is abundant. You know, favor suspends natural laws. Say favor. Suspends natural laws. When you are favored, natural laws are suspended for you. When people say it is not possible, when you get there, it shall be possible. Why? Because you carry favor. When the home office denies everybody, because you carry favor, they can't deny you. You know, when you go to the job and they say they are not taking everyone, as for you, because you carry favor, someone shout favor. Any natural law in this country or anywhere that is limiting you, may the spirit of favor suspend that law. I said, any natural law in this country or beyond that is limiting you, may the spirit of favor suspend that law. If we're here, shout, I receive that. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Someone gave me a testimony just this past week, just on Monday. He said, prophet, you know, that time you were preaching, that things that people have never done, that was 2 weeks ago. Those that came to prayer meeting, you know, Friday prayer meeting, most people don't come. But you were here, I was preaching that things you have never done before, places you have never gone before, God is going to make you go there. How many of us remember? Yes. 2 weeks ago, 2 weeks ago. He said, prophet, when you said that message, I took it personal. And this Monday, something I have been trusting God for with my wife for 10 years, it just dropped. Amen. Are you hearing me? He said something that, he said he want to prepare well and come and give a great testimony. He said, prophet, this book launch, I am coming to support with my mind, my heart, and my body. You know, he says, I took that word personal. You know, I didn't call him forward to pour oil on him. I just spoke the word and he received the word. And a miracle that has been delayed for 10 years was just released for the entire family. I pray for you. May the favor of God cause you to receive your own miracle. May the favor of God push you to your destiny. May the favor of God release that breakthrough you are looking for. May the favor of God cause you to receive your breakthrough. If you are here, shout, I receive it.
Be on your feet. Next week I'll continue. Amen. Next week I'll continue. I need to, the six things that favor will do for you.
And with the scripture that we spoke on, I didn't even touch on it. The Bible says that the oil makes your face to shine. Say the oil. Say the oil.
The oil.
Say the oil.
The oil.
Says the oil makes your face to shine. When your face shines, everywhere you go, you are light. Amen. The first thing that favor does for you is that unexplained attraction. You are just attracted to people. People just like you for no reason. That is number one thing. Today you are going to pray for the favor of God to locate you.
Thank you, Jesus.
You know, we have been doing things with our strength for far too long. Yes. Listen to me. Where labor can't take you, favor will take you.
Yes.
Where hard work, labor can't take you, the favor of God can take you.
Amen.
And note this, favor of God is the Holy Spirit, the only anointing that can suspend natural laws.
Amen.
Things can limit you, but when you carry favor, every natural law in this country and beyond shall be suspended for you.